Nintendo collectors, Alex here with another video. Hope you're well, guys. We are in the festive season. Are you getting your Christmas trees up and your tinsel? And you got the old nuts out? The old nuts. They always come out at Christmas and the old quality street. And the dates, which I can't stand. I don't do dates. And believe it or not, I don't like Christmas pudding either. It's too rich. I do like a bit of cake. I'm a bit partial to a bit of cake, as you might well know. Bit of Christmas cake, I don't mind, but Christmas pudding, oh, can't stand it. But overall, I love Christmas. Getting into the festive spirit of things with a bit of Baileys tonight. It's nearly all gone, I've finished it. But still, I'm really looking forward to doing this video, guys, because we're going to do a few things. Obviously, we've got the competition results. Which one of you guys has won a t-shirt of your choice colour? And the Game Boy with a special game to go with it. We'll have a look at that right at the end, who is the lucky winner. We're going to also go for my Wii U collection, which someone actually posted, said, why don't you do your Wii collection? Yeah, it's a bloody good idea, actually, because, you know, it's on its last leg. And we've got the new Switch coming out, so I thought it would be ideal to go through my whole Wii U collection. There's a few games I still haven't got. It's not a complete collection, but it's a collection that I like. You know, it's the games that I like, so we'll have a look at that. Also, we've got Nintendo pickups, as always. And I was going to do the arcade pickups, but you know, the problem I'm having at the moment is I'm getting home and it's too dark to film and it's too cold to go and turn them on. So we're going to have to wait to show you the arcade pickups, guys. But we've got plenty to show you this week. And also, I want to say a special thank you to all those people that voted for me for YouTuber of the Month, which I actually won, which I can't believe. So a really big thank you to all those people and all the new subs that have joined on board this channel. Thank you so much. I really appreciate it. And hats off to the other guys that were entered and nominated as well. They do a fantastic job on their channels. So go and check them out, guys. So without further ado, let's just get to the Nintendo pickups. And then we're going through the Wii U collection. And then we'll do competition results at the end. Right, guys, let's start with a lovely little gift from a friend of mine, John. Goes by the name of Jag555. You might have heard of him. He does comment quite a lot. He is involved in the community. And he came over a couple of weeks ago and we did like a little SNES trade, which I will be revealing in my next video, my SNES collecting video. But he gave me this really cool gift, which is a pretty downbeat Mario with kind of holes in his jeans and in his shoes, and he's got a bit of a ruffled moustache going on, a bit of a stubble. Reminds me of myself going to work, actually. So it's a pretty cool picture, John, and it will be going up on my wall. Really appreciate it, mate. Thank you very much, and nice to meet you at last. Also, I've got to say thank you to Graham. He's been sending me loads of super plays. Still missing quite a few. The last 10, I think it is, to complete my Super Play collection. I do already have this, Graham. As you know, it is framed on my wall, but it's nice to have another copy that I can actually flick through. Yeah, I love this cover, obviously, of my favourite game, Pocky and Rocky, and I've got it framed on my wall, so it's nice to have that. Thanks for that, Graham, really appreciate it. So, carrying on with sort of magazines, books, this is a really cool book that I picked up, Playing with Power, the NES Classics, and this is basically the first edition games that came out. It's probably about 10 games reviewed in here in quite detail. Not really reviewed, but it sort of goes into the point systems, a few of the secrets, and it's a really nice book to add to the collection. It's from the magazine Playing with Power, of course, which I didn't get back in the day. It was obviously my Sinclair Spectrum, but it's got loads of secrets, how to complete games like Excite Bike. It's got all the courses here. Can you see that, guys? Super Mario Brothers, Balloon Fight, Ice Climber. Show you some of the artwork. What other games we've got in here? Well, we've got Kid Icarus. It's got all the points for all the enemies there. Look at that. Isn't that cool? Really nice book, really do like this. Donkey Kong Jr. is in here as well, which I'm a big fan of. It's got all the levels there. It's got all the points, enemies, main characters, which is pretty cool. So yeah, it's just the first edition games covered in here and a few adverts from the magazines from back in the day, which is really funny. What's really cool about it is the cover, because it comes in this sort of NES sleeve, which the games came in. Look at that. Isn't that cool? So I've got this from Nintendo, the official Nintendo store. So I'm really chuffed with that. I haven't had a chance much to read it, but I will be reading that over Christmas, Santa Read, which would be nice. Got a few DS games here. Now this was recommended to me on a podcast. It's kind of like a, what do you call it? It's like a strategic kind of, what do you call it? Tower defense based game. It's called Ninja Town. I paid a fiver for this in CEX. I haven't played it yet, guys, but I've heard lots of good things. If you like kind of tower-based, strategic-type games, I've heard it's quite good for that, so really looking forward to playing this. £5, guys. Can't go wrong for £5. That is awesome. And I picked up this from Argos. I think it was my mate John. John, you know who you are. My SNES man, John. He alerted me that this was going in Argos quite cheap, £24. Is the Sega 3D Classics Collection for the 3DS. Got some really cool games on here. Sonic the Hedgehog, Power Drift, Altered Beast, Fantasy Zone, Maze Walker, is it? I've never heard of that one before. Galaxy Force. So there's a few arcade games in there as well. You know, I was going to get this import from Japan, because obviously I've got my Super Famicom 3DS. But they're like 3 times the price, so I just went for this option in the end, which is a shame, because I really want to get some Japanese import games for the 3DS. Oh yeah, here's a cool little one, Balloon Kid. So I believe this is like Balloon Fight, but it's kind of got a side-scrolling story to it, I think. Again, this wasn't much, but this, I paid £6 for this. I think that's all it goes for anyway, but if you try and find a box one, you're looking at about £30. It's quite a rare game, I believe, but it is very similar to a Balloon Fight. This is Balloon Kid for the Game Boy, so maybe we'll have a look at that, guys, in the video at the end. It'd be quite cool to see how that plays out. I've been picking up a few Wii U games, of course. There's not that many left that I want, and we'll go into detail in this when we look through the collection. But I'm only really interested in the limited editions, the specials now, the games that I really do like. And if I see it going cheap, I pick it up. So first up is Yoshi's Woolly World, the big box edition with the yarn Yoshi inside, which is really cool. Isabella loves this. She can't wait to take this out. I said, no, you can't. It's a collector's item. You can't take this out. So I might have to get her one now. But lovely box, lovely artwork, and I think these are only going to go out in price, guys, as soon as the Switch comes out. Give these 5-10 years time, he's going to be going for a lot of money, so good to snap them up now, I believe. And I had to get this, I've been looking for this for a long time, because it is my favourite game on the Wii U. It's the big box Super Smash Brothers for the Wii U. So this comes with the adapter, so you can add 4 GameCube controllers, which is the only way to play Super Smash Brothers. You've got to have the GameCube controllers, it's the best way. So really chuffed to get this, guys. I love the artwork. In fact, I've ordered a poster of this picture on here for my wall, because for me this sums up Nintendo, a modern day Nintendo for me. The Super Smash Brothers, all the characters there. Such an awesome picture, so I can't wait to receive that, stick that on the wall. But what a great, fantastic piece of artwork that is on there. Look at that, guys. It's got all the characters on there. Well, not all of them, but the main ones, Zelda and Icarus, Donkey Kong and Samus. Absolutely love this game. We'll go into a bit more detail this when we have a look at the Wii U games. And another game, I've been hunting this down for ages. They go for quite a lot of money now. You're looking at about 120, 130 quid. But if you're patient, they do come up, guys. And sure enough, I was in CEX when I bought that Ninja Town. It was in there, sitting on the shelf, 80 quid, obviously pre-owned. But it's the beautiful, I can't wait to play this, guys. I haven't played it yet. It's Fire Emblem Fates in the limited edition box. How cool is that? I absolutely love this game. Love the last one. Can't wait to play this one. So basically this is all three games on one cart. Because when she got it out, I said to her, I'll make sure there's three games in there. And she went off, tried looking for the other two games, and she was gone for about 10 minutes. I thought, is there three games in there? I had to quickly look on my phone, and no, it's, all the games are on one cart. So all you get in here is basically the normal box, well, this special box, which is Fire Emblem Fates, because all the other games have their own boxes, and you get a tin, so you could put your game in the tin box, which is really cool. It's got lovely box art on there. Look at that, guys. Absolutely beautiful. And you know what? I don't own the new 3DS. I've got to look into whether they do like a Fire Emblem 3DS limited edition, which would be cool to get. Because I really do love this game. I could sit here for hours playing this game. But how beautiful is that box art? Really nice. And it comes with an art book as well. You know, if it's your favourite game, why not splash out on, you know, the limited edition? Why not? I'd rather do that than buy 10 games that I'm never going to play just to say I've got a complete collection of the Wii U. Do you know what I mean? I'd rather have, rather direct my money into something that I really do enjoy playing, where I love the artwork, I love everything that's gone into the game. I'd rather spend that little bit more, and that's how my collection goes these days, is I'd rather just pay more for the games that I really do love. So this is a really cool art book, guys. Don't know if you can see, look, some of the cool pictures in here. Look at that. So if you love the game, why not get the special edition with all the artwork? And it's absolutely beautiful. I can't wait to get to my teeth into this game. So yeah, that's really, really nice. And it comes with a poster as well. So maybe, I don't know. Could look at getting this, get this framed as well, which would go on the wall, look quite nice. You've got the map there, and again you've got all the characters there. Absolutely lovely, really, really nice. Lovely box, limited box edition. So basically you've got Birthright, Conquest and Revelation. Three games to play, one cart. Ah, can't wait to play that. So I think that is it. Is that all my pickups? That is all my pickups, guys. Also, I've got the arcade pickups, but the trouble is, every time I get home, it's dark. I'll see if I can fit that in at the end of the video. But for now, let's go and have a look at my Wii U collection. Just go through all the Wii U games I've picked up over its lifespan, and let you tell me what is your favourite game in the Wii U collection, and see where I've gone with my collection. Right, guys, so let's get straight into it. The Wii U, did you think it was a good enough console? What was wrong with it? Well, I think the three main things that were wrong with the Wii U was, first of all, was its name. It had really bad marketing. A lot of casual gamers, a lot of parents going to shops probably just thought it was the Wii, to be honest with you, or an updated Wii, which it was, in effect. It was, that's just a HD version of the Wii. But, you know, if they changed the name, I think it could have done a lot better than it had done. Also, it didn't have the third-party support. Very small library of games compared to the other consoles at the time. And of course, if you haven't got the third party, you know, Nintendo have got to put out a lot of in-house games. And I think a lot of the games they've got wrong, to be honest with you. They were rushed out. And unfortunately, that didn't look good. Especially with games like Star Fox. It just seemed rushed to me. So, yeah, those were the biggest things, I think. And obviously the control mechanism, the Wii U pad, you know, a lot of games were forced to use it, and I don't think really they had to. You know, you had to play a lot of games by looking at the pad. And I don't see the point of that. You might as well play on the 3DS, because a lot of these games you could get on the 3DS and already played on the 3DS. So why would I go and play the same game on the Wii U just to play on the pad? It just didn't interest me, and I lost interest very quickly. So, yeah, I mean, it was a good console. Some really good games on it, but not enough. Not enough good games, unfortunately. Not enough variation in games as well. people would say too kiddie orientated. I don't believe they're too kiddie orientated. They're characters that have come from sort of the 80s. They've brought them up to date. That doesn't bother me. I love the bright colours of Nintendo. I think they look fantastic. And, you know, I like escapism when I play a game. I don't want things to look realistic. You know, you're playing a simulation in effect. You know, I can appreciate they're good games. There's a lot of depth to them. But when they get too realistic, they lose that magic, to be honest with you. That's my opinion anyway. So let's get straight into it. I've got about 35 games here, I think, 40 maybe, haven't counted, but let's just start off with Kirby's and Rainbow Paintbrush. Again, the previous year I played this on the DS, pretty much exactly the same game, and I got bored of this very quickly. Even Isabella got bored of this very quickly. Just staring at the pad just didn't do it for me. Again, I think it worked well on the DS, but again, it just seemed like a port from that. Nothing special about this game whatsoever. Pikmin 3, really enjoyed this game. We've finished this about three times. I finished it, Trish's son's finished it, and I've played through again with Isabelle, and she's really enjoying it because she loves all the little characters. This is a great little management game. Fantastic. Again, you know, this is what Nintendo do best. Zombie U, this was an early release for the Wii U. I couldn't get into it, to be honest with you. Again, the control system didn't do it for me, unfortunately. And I'm not really into zombie games unless I'm really blasting the hell out of them like a light gun game. Ninja Gaiden Razor's Edge 3. This had real bad camera angle issues. The camera on this camera was terrible. And that was its biggest downfall. I really enjoyed Ninja Gaiden Black on the 360. That was a fantastic game. Rock hard, but I really enjoyed that. Really felt you achieved something. But with this, unfortunately, the camera angle did let it down. Mass Effect 3. I played the first one. I don't know why I picked up this one, because I did enjoy the first one. Just not for me, guys. Just too much dialogue. Too slow-paced, in my opinion. NBA. I love NBA Jam on the Super Nintendo. I guess I was kind of looking for that. But again, this is too realistic for me. It's like a simulation. Just doesn't do it for me. I want a bit of fun, you know. Big slam dunks and the ball going on fire and stuff like that. Lego Jurassic Park. I really bought this for Isabella, but she didn't get into it. Neither did I. The Wonderful 101. Try and pick this up, guys. I think this could be a rare game in the future. Quite an expensive game to get hold of. It's an early release. You don't see them anymore. I haven't played it yet. I think I played the demo when it first came out. Quite enjoyed it. So it is a game I will go back to. Splatoon. I had a bit of fun with this. It was okay. But again, the control system I couldn't get on with. I know you can use the Pro, but most people actually said that, you know, if you can get used to using the pad, it does work better. You do get used to it. But I don't know, it wasn't a game for me, guys. My favourite game on the Wii U, Super Smash Bros., as you know. I got into Brawl on the Wii. I think that was a fantastic game, and it had the story line you could walk through, but it was missing the storyline on this. But I still think this is a fantastic game because the mechanics of this work perfectly. It's such a competitive game. Lots of people playing this competitively around the world. The roster of characters was just, they just nailed it. Every single character you could think of is in it. You know, when they introduced Ryu and Bayonetta, I was just totally blown away. This is such a good game. It took me ages to get into. I was determined to work it out, and I finally did, and really, really enjoy this. I just play one-on-one and really enjoy it. Such a good game. Nintendo Land. There's a couple of good games on here, not that many. I was a little bit disappointed with it, but you know, we've had a bit of fun with it, me and Isabella. It's okay. Early release. I think that was packaged with the Wii U to begin with. Injustice. I finished the storyline. Again, I think you really need to play this online two players, but if I was going to do that, it'd be with Smash Brothers or Street Fighter. It's okay. I'm not really into Marvel sort of superheroes, so that's not an attraction for me. But it was okay. It was alright. Not a bad game. Steamwell High, Steamwell Dig. Haven't played that, still sealed. I will get round to it. Paper Mario Colour Splash. I played about half an hour of this game and it still hasn't drawn me in. I just find the combat system a little bit kind of repetitive. But I mean, I think it does get better. So maybe I've got to give this a little bit more time. It does look beautiful though. Beautiful looking game. Game & Wario. I absolutely love the WarioWare games, the Game & Wario games. And I was really disappointed with this. There's a couple of fun games on here. But overall, it's not as good as the Game Boy Advance version. That is the nuts. That is so cool. So I was a little bit disappointed with it, but there are some fun games and it is worth getting if you can pick it up cheap, guys. It is a lot of fun. Rayman Legends, oh, what a game. This was absolutely awesome. I've yet to finish this. I guess I'm about halfway through. Graphically, it looks superb. The artistic direction in this is unbelievable. And the music, such a good game. A must have for your Wii U, guys. Lego City Undercover. I haven't played this yet. I've heard it is probably one of the best Lego games. It kind of takes it from Grand Theft Auto, which I'm not a big fan of anyway, but I think this is a lot more fun, which is what I like. But yeah, I've got to get around to playing that. It looks really good. Fast Racing Neo. This is a fast racing game. It almost feels like your eyes are coming out of your sockets. You're trying to concentrate on the tracks. You really got to learn the tracks in this, guys. It's a lot of fun. A lot of people said this should have been the F-Zero. It should have been. But F-Zero is a little bit more fun than this. This is quite a serious racing game with some pumping music. But it is good and definitely worth owning for the Wii U. Zelda Twilight Princess HD, which I actually do have the limited box edition. I finished this on the Wii U. I have no intention of playing it on the HD. It was a fantastic game, really enjoyed it, but it's a really long game, guys. It's a brilliant game, it really is, but I don't think I could stomach going through it again. There's other Zelda games I haven't played yet, which I'd rather play first, but definitely worth owning. If you haven't played it, go out and buy it, guys. It is absolutely brilliant. Rodea the Sky Soldier. Again, this had problems with the controls. It just didn't work. Again, I think this was rushed out, to be honest with you. But I have heard it comes with two discs. You've got the Wii version and the Wii U version. And I have heard that the Wii version is the better of the two. So maybe I should give that a go. I've actually got the 3DS version of this as well, which is terrible. Plays awful. But I've got to give the Wii version a go, guys, just to give it some good credit. Yoshi's Woolly World, which is a fantastic game. First of all, I couldn't get into it because I think it was just because I'd just finished Yoshi's Island, I think it was, on the 3DS. So, you know, I think I was a little bit burnt out with Yoshi's World, but I finally got into it and really enjoyed it. Absolutely looks beautiful and some very clever puzzles in this game. Lovely box, limited edition box, if you can get that, guys, with the Yoshi's Yarn, which is cool. Project Zero, this was a fairly recent pickup. If you've been following my videos, you can get a limited edition box of this. I won't be getting it because I don't think the game's as good as to warrant getting a limited edition box, because I just get the ones of my favourite games. And it's a good game. I just found it was a little bit repetitive. Again, I found it a little bit annoying with the control system, trying to get the circles, the recycles lined up. But it is a good game. It's very atmospheric. If you like your sort of Resident Evil sort of stuff, you're going to enjoy this. And it's really scary, guys. Super Mario Wii U. I found this too hard. Too hard, guys. Rock hard. Couldn't get into it, to be honest with you. I prefer the 3DS versions, to be honest with you. I've yet to get the Luigi version. I don't know whether that's harder or easier. I've got no idea. Maybe I should give that a go. But I did find this a little bit too hard, guys. Super Mario Maker. I was really looking forward to getting this. designing all my own levels, but I ended up just playing other people's levels. I couldn't be bothered making my own. I enjoyed just playing other people. I think it was a fantastic game, but it didn't last long. I guess I played it for about a month and then got a bit bored of it. But still, lovely box. Look at that, guys. Lovely box art on there. Comes with a little art book and a little sort of 8-bit Mario, which is really cool. So if you like the Mario games, you've got to own this. What can I say? Mario Kart 8. I was going to say one of the best Mario Kart games, but it's missing the battle game. The battle game just didn't have it. Why did they have a big track? You know, you need to have like a small area to play two players against each other. Because otherwise you're just going round and round trying to find each other on a big track. It just didn't work. The battle game on the SNES is the best by far, and maybe the N64 version, that was a good game as well. But other than that, the actual racing part of this game was superb. I mean, what a fantastic HD update, it really was. My favourite track has to be the airport with the planes. When you jump off and the planes are coming over the top of you, that was just absolutely awesome. Some amazing tracks in there, great fun online. Always easy to find someone to play with. Great updates as well. New tracks. I love the Excite Bike track. That was absolutely awesome. A game I will go back to. Absolutely brilliant. Just a shame the battle game was a bit of a letdown. You know, they just should have made it just a smaller area so you could find each other. That was quite easy enough to do. We just didn't do it. Oh, what a game, Hyrule Warriors. I absolutely love this game. I love Dynasty Warriors. If you like those type of games, you're gonna love this in a Hyrule world. Brilliant, fantastic updates with amiibo support. Really enjoyed this game. In fact, I really wanna go back into this. I've got my limited edition on its way. I'm gonna go back into this game. Fantastic. Donkey Kong Country, Tropical Freeze. I've yet to finish this. Another fantastic game, a must own for the Wii U. Absolutely brilliant. Love the music in this game. Graphically, it looks superb. Just an awesome game, guys. Probably one of the best platform games I've ever played. It really, really is. And the best Donkey Kong Country game I've ever played. A must have for your Wii U, guys. Bayonetta and Bayonetta 2. This is not the special edition box. I loved Bayonetta on the 360. It was my favourite game on the 360, and when I found out it had a Bayonetta 2 was coming out for the Wii U, I was just blown away. I couldn't believe it. Thought this is it, it's gonna make the Wii U a bestseller. I don't think it sold that well in the end. I think Nintendo had to spend a lot of money supporting the company, Platinum Games, to make the game, to finish it off. But it was absolutely brilliant. I just didn't like the fact that she had her hair cut. I preferred her hair long. But yeah, what a brilliant game. If you love sort of Devil May Cry, fast, action-paced, get to know your combos, it's absolutely brilliant game. Massive, ridiculous bosses. Just a superb, so much style to this game. Unbelievable. Super Mario 3D World. Again, what can I say? This is what Nintendo do best. Fantastic level design. Beautiful looking graphics, colourful, bright, vibrant colours. Just everything you want from Nintendo and from a Mario game. Absolutely love this game. And here is my Super Smash Bros. Limited edition box, which I showed you in the last video with the adapter for the controllers, so you can use your GameCube controllers. My favourite game on the Wii U. Brilliant. With the roster of all the characters. And is my favourite fighting game to go to. Captain Toad's Treasure Tracker. I'm about 3 or 4 levels away from finishing this game. Very short, quite easy, but very enjoyable. A lot of character to this. Very charming little game. Must have for your collection. This is probably my last one, is it? Yeah, my last one is, yeah, probably one of my favourite games of all time. My favourite Zelda game, and that's Wind Waker. Absolutely beautiful game. What the music, again, I go on about very creative, level design, very cleverly done, very thought-provoking, just makes you think for ages, and then when you find out, it's like, wow, yeah, that was so clever. How well was that done? Absolutely brilliant game. I've finished this about four times now, twice on the Wii U and twice on the GameCube. This is a must-have for the collection. It comes with a Ganondorf. I think these go for a bit of money now, guys, but if you can get hold of one, it's well worth having, because that is a beautiful figurine to have in your collection, which I have on display on my shelf. So that is it. That is my Wii U collection, I believe it is. Hope you enjoyed that, guys. There's still a few more I want to get. There's Tokyo Mirage Sessions and Xenoblade Chronicles. I think it's the Pokemon Tournament, the fighting game. And there's a couple of us, Mario Party 8, and I'm pretty much done with the Wii U. That's it. Can't wait for the Switch to come out. So, let's get on to the old competition results. I know you're dying to find out who's won. Let's go and check it out, guys. Right, competition results, guys. Which one of you has won a t-shirt, a colour of your choice, and this lovely Game Boy Color, and the brilliant... my favourite game on the Game Boy, which is Donkey Kong. This is a fantastic game. It's got a real twist in it, so if you haven't played this, I think you're really going to enjoy this. It's a really great game. One of my favourite games on the Game Boy. So let's find out who the winner's going to be. Now, a lot of you entered. A few of you got it wrong. And I think you probably just Wikipedia'd it. And you probably would have got the wrong answer if you'd done that, because it just takes you straight to the Bandido version of Sheriff, which is made by Exidy, and the damsel in distress is Pretty Priscilla, which is the wrong answer, of course. We wanted a Nintendo damsel in distress, which is Betty, believe it or not. Which I know there's not a lot of info out there, but you only had to go back and look at my videos to find out, guys, and I mentioned it a few times in a few of my videos. Some of you actually said Pauline as well, which Pauline's actually out of Donkey Kong. So again, that is the wrong answer. So I've got a few right answers here, and what we're going to do is we're going to fold them up and put them in the bowl, have a little mix round, and I'm going to pick the lucky winner. Okay, so I'm going to read out all the people that got the answer right. Starting first off with Nick Berry. Well done, Nick, who was nominated for YouTuber of the Month. If you go and check that out, guys. Good old Nick, he's got a fantastic channel. Stefan Olsen, been following my channel for ages. Well done, Stefan. In the bowl, I'll hold the bowl up. It's all going in there, look, guys, I'm just folding them up. Ian Cullen, well done, mate. Your name goes in the bowl. Tootie, thanks for entering, Tootie. Stuart, well done, mate. Peter, Paul from Holland, well done, Peter. You've been following me for a long time. I really appreciate your support, Peter. Top bloke. Adam Medbury, well done, mate. Chris Miller, well done, Chris. Andrew Anderson, well done, Andrew. Daniel Copeland, he's been following the channel for a long time. Well done, mate. Matt, the Video Game Carnival, he's always at Revival and Replay with his little Video Game Carnival set up. Well done, mate. Nice to see you the other month at Revival. Kyle Brian, if I got your name right. Well done, Kyle, another good follower of my channel. Joe Aspinall, well done, Joe. Misha, well done, Misha. Names in the hat, or in the bowl, as the saying goes. TL Thomas, well done, Thomas. Luke Abossum, sorry if I'm butchering your name there. Yeah, I think it's Luke Abossum, or Abossum, sorry, mate. Aaron, well done, Aaron. Stephen, I've got your emails all written down, so I know who you are. If you get it right, I can just text you. Paul Galton, well done, Paul. Ian McGrath from up north, Scotland. Well done, Ian. Good channel. Go and check his video YouTube channel out. Andreas from Austria. Well done, Andreas. Been following the channel for a long time. God, I'm going to butcher this name. Martin or Martigin D. Tom or Tatome. Sorry, mate, I've butchered that name, but I know I've got your email. If you get it right, I'll email you. And Wojtek Straka, well done, mate. Your name is in the bowl. So there's all the names in the bowl. Which is the lucky winner? Which one's going to win the T-shirt and the Game Boy with Donkey Kong? Let's have a good old feel around. I'm not going to look. Okay, let's get that on camera so you can see. Just going to pick one out. Got one. And it is Chris Miller. Well done, Chris. You've won the T-shirt and the Game Boy with Donkey Kong. Well done, guys. Fantastic. Well, that is it for this week. My next video is going to be the SNES collection video. You've got to check this one out, guys. I've got some lovely pickups in this next SNES collection video. I just want to say a huge thank you again to all those people that nominated me, voted for me for YouTuber of the Month. Really appreciate that. So I've only got really one more video before Christmas. I'm going to do a Christmas video and that's it for this year. I'm going to take a little bit of a break, play some games, and then we'll be back in the new year. But I've got hopefully two more videos before the new year anyway. So that's it, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video and thanks for watching. Thanks for all the new subs as well. See you on the next one.